Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology, and we are back with Shikha ji again, once again. And last time, 2 weeks back, we had done this recording on Shurak, and people just went crazy after seeing that video. There were so many comments I have seen, and so many people have messaged me. They have mailed me saying that we did not know anything about shoes, and we never thought that shoe racks could be such an important area in our life. I mean, not in a significant way, but if it is not kept properly in the right place or in the right way, then it could really create a wreck havoc in your life. So similarly, today the topic is mirrors. So where
Thank
should
you.
we keep mirrors, and what, how? It's all about mirrors today, so stay tuned. And she also has a YouTube channel, which most of you will be aware of. And in case you have not visited, then please check the link in the description section. And you also do consultations, and you are also having courses, I guess. So whatever it is, yeah, you can say, and I will pin the link in the description section. Welcome, madam, and this is all yours.
Thank you so much, Babuji ji. Yeah, even I was surprised to see this shoe rack on your channel. People have messaged me personally about it, and yes, we actually don't think ki these things are important, but they do matter. Yeah, I think the basics of Vastu everyone should know, because even if I don't do remedies, even if I sit in a correct place, face the correct direction while eating, sleeping, studying, not sitting under a beam, all these small, small things, they all get clarified in us, and they bring a lot of change and positive vibrations in our day-to-day lives. So people had suggested the videos about a kitchen placement, I think, and but many had asked for mirror placements and all that, and the effects of mirrors. So today let's talk a little bit about mirrors, whatever I know. And it is actually mirrors in Vastu play a very, very important role. The mirrors are used in as remedies in many places, in many zones. Now, mirrors basically is the water element. So whenever my water zone is disturbed or it is cut, or there is heavy weight over there, there is a entrance door over there, I say a heavy cupboard placed in the water zone, or we have a blocked water zone, then these mirrors come into effect. Like if I place a mirror over there, the remedies are done, and they really work very beautifully. But opposed to that, if I place mirrors in the opposite direction, like say earth element or the fire element, so they give very bad results.
Okay.
Okay, so basically, if you see, the mirrors should be hung on the north, northeast, and the eastern walls.
North, northeast, and east.
Eastern walls, yes. They should
Okay.
not be
Okay.
placed. Yeah, because it is here that they this is the water zone. From
Okay.
0 degrees north to 90 degrees east is the water zone.
Okay.
So mirrors should go only there. Even if you have, say suppose now you don't have any windows on the north, and there is a window on the east. So I'll place a mirror on the north. The rays of the sun enter the east, strike the north wall, activating the north.
Okay. Interesting.
And the north, yeah, and the devta of the north wall is Kubera. That is
Okay.
a god, treasurer of money. Everyone knows about Kubera. I don't need to talk about him, right?
Yes.
So it's a very important remedy we can do if the north is blocked. A special remedy for this. But simultaneously, if say suppose there is a mirror in the southwest or the south, then we should not use the mirror, and this mirror should always be kept hidden by a curtain or something. You just put a curtain over it and
Okay,
use
so it
it
is
only when
already
you
hidden.
need to. You need use it only when you need to use it.
Okay, not for daily purposes.
Daily purpose. Suppose I have a bedroom in southwest and the mirror does not have a place in the east or the north wall in the bedroom.
Okay.
So maybe I have put the mirror on the south, southwest, or the west wall. So I need to get dressed up every day. So those 2 minutes I can open the curtain, get dressed up.
Okay,
Rest of the
so
time it's covered with
rest
the
of the time
curtain.
it should be covered. Okay, I see. Okay. So does that
So
like minimize the bad effect or something like?
when the reflection is not there, no? When once the
Okay.
curtain comes, the reflection is not there.
Okay, got it.
So the see in the mirror when you see the image is as far as you are standing in front of it. Suppose I'm
Correct.
standing 2 feet in front of the mirror, so my reflection is 2 feet behind the mirror.
Correct.
So if I'm putting the mirrors in the sink areas, these are called as sink areas, south, southwest, west, then they enlarge that area,
Okay.
which we don't want to be enlarged.
Okay, I see.
So basic concept is that nobody understands the meaning of all such things. So it's very, very important to learn these basics, the Vedic way, why the mirrors are kept only in the source areas and not the sink areas and all that.
Okay. Okay. And in
Then
case it is there in that and somebody does not put, then like what kind of problems come generally if the mirrors are not rightly placed?
it will now depend upon further things also, whatever the faults in the house, it will change from
Okay.
premise to premise. What are the cuts? What is happening in the south? South is open. Then this amplifies the negative effect.
Okay, and you said this is like representing the water element. So does it show that some emotional unhappiness can be there or something like this?
Yes, total. Nahi, me. Yeah, of course. Emotionally, you are very, very disturbed if you have
Oh.
these mirrors. And besides being emotional, even see, a water element is controlled by the moon, right?
Correct.
So you may have problems in thinking, no right thinking, no right decisions. Even
Oh, got
being
it.
represented by water,
Correct, Venus.
planet. So money issues. All
Okay.
such things, right?
Okay. So
Because
the
the ruler of
planets.
south, yeah, because the ruler of southwest is Niruti,
Oh,
and we
okay.
all know who is Niruti.
Oh,
The ruler of
yes.
south is Yama.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So we don't want to amplify the effects of these gods, no? Demons. These
Okay.
are the demons.
Okay. In earlier times, they also used to say if a mirror would fall down, that shows somebody may pass away in the family. It's like big inauspicious sign or something like this.
There were many, many shaguns. We call this shaguns or omens.
Okay, correct. Correct.
I remember a case. One of my aunt and uncle, they have this business of glasses, the windows, no? They make sliding windows.
Okay.
So they had big godowns where they kept these glasses used for the sliding windows. And one day, all the glasses, there was something had happened, and all the glasses broke. And they had a loss of lakhs and lakhs. This was, say, 30 years back, 30, 40 years back,
Okay.
30, 35 years back. And the same day, my aunt had gone for a report to the doctor. So the breaking of the glasses, and she connected it with. She got a report ki she was a diabetic patient. Matlab, that was the day it
Okay.
was detected.
Oh, I
But
see.
after that, yeah. So she said, I came to know about it timely. She lived a long life after that.
Correct.
So
Okay.
she said, okay, the glasses gave me an indication ki there is a problem, but it will go away because the glasses broke off. So whatever had come as a bad thing for her, it had gone away because the glasses had broken. That's what we
Oh,
she said, and we were just small children that time.
okay.
Whenever I remember about this mirrors and glasses, now I recollect this.
Okay, I see.
And both of them were very good astrologers, the husband and a wife.
Okay.
And they always used to tell me, go and learn astrology, especially my uncle. But it took me 10 long years after their saying to get into astrology. Yeah. So, and then if you keep proper mirrors at proper places, they give bring in lots of positivity. And they give you a lot of things. And this I do, I'm doing Vastu in so many places. So I have seen the effects of this.
And sometimes, like, I have seen people keeping mirrors within their drawer, or they open a shelf and then there is a mirror. So,
I'm coming to that. Yeah.
okay.
So there is another thing, like basically in a bedroom there should be no mirrors,
Okay, I see.
because then the mirrors, the reflections, the rays hitting the mirrors and whatever the light hitting, everything disturbs our sleep and the rest.
Okay, so like anywhere, there should be no mirrors.
Basically, in the olden days, they all never used to keep a mirror or a TV in the bedroom.
Oh, yes, correct. Correct.
Nowadays, it is a compulsion we have to keep the mirrors. So, a mirror should, first thing I told you, it on the north wall or the east wall. Try to get
Okay.
the mirror on the north wall or the east wall. But care should be taken that the bed is not reflected in the mirror.
Okay, so this is you are saying if it is somehow unfortunately in the bedroom.
Yeah. No, today if I go to see na, every bedroom needs a mirror. Period.
Yeah, the dressing table for ladies especially.
For everyone, even for
Yeah.
men, or means if a couple is using a bedroom or someone, say it is a my son is using a bedroom, so he won't come to my bedroom to get dressed.
Correct,
He needs
correct.
space, right?
Correct.
So that time care should be, only care should be taken that it does not reflect the bed.
Okay, so when you see the mirror, you should not see the bed in the mirror. That's all.
Correct.
Okay.
And the mirror should not be from floor to ceiling. It
Okay.
should start from 3 to 4 feet from the floor. Like
Okay.
say, suppose this is my floor, so the mirror should start from here.
Okay, it should not touch the ground.
Yeah. So
Okay.
nowadays everyone wants big mirrors, interior designings. They give you mirror here, there. They say the house looks big and all that. So please say no to them. I don't want it.
Okay, I see. And what is like the any reason why it should not touch the ground?
Not touch the ground means the mirror should not be full length.
Okay.
It should start from 3.5 feet,
Correct.
like
Okay.
that. That is a standard. Then even in the washrooms or your powder rooms, the mirror should be on the north and the eastern walls.
Even inside the room, bedroom, also the bathroom and all this. Okay.
Yeah. And then these mirrors should never be broken or cracked. Immediately replace whatever is broken. Don't keep broken mirrors, broken glasses, or broken crockery at home. Even if you have a crack in the cup, don't use it, just throw it off.
Okay. And regarding this,
So,
you said I had a question that you should not use mirrors in the bedroom, especially. So then, where is there any room where we should keep mirrors, or is it like allowed in other
yeah,
rooms?
so I'm very happy to see nowadays they have walk-in wardrobes.
Okay.
That trend is coming back. So
Okay,
I feel
what is
a
that?
mirror over walk-in wardrobes. You know,
Okay.
apart from the bedroom, they have an area where the
Okay,
wardrobe is built.
separate. Correct, correct.
Get dressed over there.
Okay. This was there earlier, but
Correct. Correct,
yeah.
correct. And because then we shifted into apartments and the apartments got smaller and smaller in size, so everything comes in one place. many of the places that are not possible.
Yeah, generally I remember when I used to visit these circuit houses, the British made bungalows, big, like government bungalows there. The bedroom would be there, then there would be a dressing room, then there would be the bathroom. And there
Correct,
used to be a
correct.
door in between. Very clear this was.
Yes, very true. So, yeah, that trend is coming back again, and mostly like, so I'm happy with that. But I still tell you, na, matlab, where there is nothing, na, so then you go ahead and place a mirror on, but your care should be taken, it should be on the eastern wall or the northern wall and not reflecting the back bed. That's it. Most of the time, I get to do that. It's very rarely I cannot do that. Very rarely I cannot do that. And then the mirrors in the rectangular shape are the best. Square shape and rectangle, they say, are the best. These should be used. Even if there are window panes, like window panes, keep window panes which are not transparent. Because even they form the reflection surfaces, glasses of windows. Therefore, we put curtains on windows, you know.
I got it.
Yes. So all this care about mirrors is to be taken, and a mirror should not be straight in front of your main door. Like a main door opens and you directly look into the mirror. That should not be there.
And you said about like what about circular mirrors? They are okay.
No, only square mirrors or rectangular
Okay, circles are not good.
mirrors.
Okay, I see.
Okay, and you asked me a question, where should mirrors be kept? So mirrors are okay in living rooms or a dining room also, a mirror is good. Because that is a family time, people sitting together, eating food together.
Correct.
So it is okay. Entrance way, it should not be in the entrance, as a, like, it should not reflect the entrance door. It should not reflect a staircase. The mirror should not reflect a staircase. These all care should be taken. Then, in many places, I see ki, the mirrors are kept opposite to each other. Like this mirror will reflect everything in this mirror and this river.
Correct.
Have you seen that? So this is also a big no-no. Yeah. So this also care should be taken ki no, not to be that.
I see.
Any other question? I think I have covered a lot of things.
And suppose if like there is a mirror in one place and it's like sticking to the wall and you can't do anything, so then we use the same thing, we put curtains or we cover it. That's the only thing we can do.
Very easy, you just have to put two nails and put a wire and put a curtain. Very easy
So
to do it.
basically, if it is there in a place, sometimes people have these questions that we purchase the fully furnished apartment and there are mirrors are sticking here, there, we can't remove them, the owner doesn't allow them, just cover.
Just cover it off.
And one
I forgot.
question, one, yeah.
I forgot to say ki, many of them, they have mirrors on the wardrobe doors,
Exactly,
right?
correct.
That also is a big no-no, right? But you can keep mirrors in cash boxes or wherever you keep your treasures. But that also has to be carefully planned. You just cannot keep a mirror. Like it has to be carefully planned. Which direction that mirror falls into inside the cash box. I
Correct.
designed special cash boxes, treasure boxes. So care has to be taken over there also.
Because then if it reflects that, then the money is multiplied. That's the reason.
Correct, correct.
And like, have you seen sometimes that If mirrors are like badly placed, then there's too much quarrel within the family or disharmony in relationships or anything like this you have like seen practically.
Yeah, see, most of the time what happens is people will contact us for consultations only when they are in problem.
Yeah.
Right. So
Yes.
when I visit their places, then of course, then this is one point that I'm very careful ki I should have a look at all the mirrors where they are placed.
Okay.
That is a means apart from all the faults in their places. Like they, most of them will have money problems or relationship issues or whatever it is. Then I also look key mirrors placed in the wrong direction, shoe racks, whatever. What so many negative things can be there, no?
Okay. So it's not like only one or two, there can be multiple things depending on the other problems.
Yes, right. Only mirrors, if I visit a premises, everything is there.
Oh, yes.
Now, I cannot only say, this mirror is here, so this has become the problem. It is not
Okay.
like that.
Correct,
But
correct, correct.
there is a point system in Vastu that we use in
Okay.
grading a house. So these points, if there are faults, they keep on multiplying each other.
Okay.
Yeah, and this point system, without this point system, we cannot work. Say, suppose a person comes and tells me, ma'am, I have seen 10 houses and come and choose the best house for me.
Okay.
Now, today, in today's this thing, nothing is 100% Vastu compliant.
Oh, I see.
So then from out of that 10 houses, what do I choose? I will sit and work out the positive points, the negative points, give them a point system, and the one with the less faults, I'll tell him you can pay this.
Okay, I see.
That is a way to go about it.
Okay, interesting. And anything like these rules are general for everybody, or this is like,
Yeah,
or it changes
everybody.
sometimes depending on the flats or like your own
No,
home.
no.
It has nothing
Oh,
to
no,
do.
no, no. General
And
Vastu.
these will hold true also if this is a office, not a living room or anything. It's true for
Places, sometimes the rules change.
all.
Like
Okay.
mirrors in, you can say, mirrors in saloons, they have different set
Aha.
of rules.
Oh.
And mirrors in bars and everything, they have different sets of rules. But this is common for rest of the things,
Okay, like
like
your
especially a
own home
home
and all this. Okay.
and something like that.
Okay. Great. Incredible. It's so many new things I learn always.
Yeah, Vastu is really interesting, and small points. Even if I tell ki even if you don't have the money to do remedies, only if you do small things na, that also change the atmosphere of the house.
Okay. Nice.
Okay. Yeah.
Great. Thank you very much. And I hope we will again record like two rack and today mirrors on some other topic.
Sure, we will.
Yes. Okay.
Thank
Thank you very much. And for those who have not visited our channel, please go down in the description section. You'll find our YouTube channel and our website for consultations. Okay. Thank you very much. Yes, Sriram.